Straight to questions.
EJ, kind of like we asked Sabina, just, you know, what was it like, just the team rallying around with Gary was let go and whatnot, and coming out last week like you guys did?
Of course, it was a big loss. I mean, of course, you know that, but Coach Gill did a really good job taking over, and really not much has changed since Coach P left. Preparation still the same. We still prepare the same. Attention to detail and just preparing for each opponent the same. It hasn't changed. So.
Some of the plays the offense made, the Chandler made, how that energized the defense?
I mean, we kind of try to work off each other all the time, try to encourage each other. I mean, I feel like we put together a great football game as a unit, offense and defense. And I feel like that really helped. We made some big plays, not a lot of mistakes. I mean, that was a real big win. Like you said, we wanted to get that one for the TCU Horned Frog Nation, for Coach Patterson. Just that was a win that was really much needed.
What's your early thoughts on Oklahoma State? They're obviously always known as a pretty good offense and can put some points up on the board.
Real good team. Like I said, preparation still not going to change. We're going to prepare for Oklahoma State just like we prepared for Baylor, just like we prepared for K-State and the teams previous before them. So, just want to take a step in the right direction today. Good work week, good work day. Come out with a lot of energy and just do what we need to do to make sure we come up on top of Saturday.
TJ, you not only transitioned into a new defense this year, but at a new position. Talk about how you feel like you've grown so far this season.
I feel like I've definitely grown from a mental aspect of knowing the game more. Like I feel like I go into the game, like I can't just play for me. I got to know, because I'm the general on the back end, so I'm giving everybody calls. Telling them what to do. So I feel like from a mental aspect of the game, I've grown a lot.
Do you take pride in like carrying that level of responsibility?
I love that responsibility. It's been fun. It's been a fun journey.
TJ, we were just talking about it, but just how big was that play where Trey was able to tip it up and Keon intercepted it in Keon's first game back? Just mm-hmm. How big was that for y'all defensively for the flow of the game?
That was a big play. Takeaways are always big. Anytime you get a takeaway, it's a big play, big momentum shift for the whole team. So, like you said, Trey just made a great play coming off his man. Wasn't even his man. He came off the guy he was on and came and made a good play, and Keon picked it. And that was a big momentum swing for the whole team, and I feel like it really helped.
And just on the Shadrack's interception, just with his move from A&M to TCU, a lot of people talking about him, making assumptions about him. What can you say about the teammate and the just the player he's been since he's been at TCU?
Well, Shadrack has been good. Like, kind of piggyback off what Obina said, like, talent, we ain't worried about talent. Like, we got talent everywhere, across the field, every position. He came in. Every time he came in, it seemed like he was making a play, but we knew what type of player he was. So, I really don't accept, like we said, we already know what he could do. And not only him, but a lot of other players on the team as well. It's just when they get the opportunity, just taking advantage of that.
When you see guys stepping up like that who haven't had a lot of playing time, what kind of confidence does that give you as a whole moving forward?
I mean, like I said, it goes back to knowing ourselves. Like, we know what we got at the end of the day. It's just finding a way to make sure we're 1 point better than the other team when it comes Saturday. So.
Yeah, I know it's only your first year here, but obviously you've played a lot of football at this level. What do you tell the younger guys? Because it seems like a coaching change, guys could have checked out, but just as one of the leaders or more veteran guys, what do you tell them to kind of stay in there?
I mean, you just got to control the controllables, control what you can control. I mean, I've been in college for 5 years, my fifth year. I done had 4 different coordinators, 4 different position coaches, 3 different head coaches. See what I'm saying? It's a business. It's just hard work. You just control what you can control.
TJ, just kind of big picture here. As a guy who came from the AAC, what do you think about the way the college football playoff is, and especially this year with the way Cincinnati seems to be kind of getting disrespected? Mm-hmm. Do you think there needs to be a change in the way that they make selections?
I mean, that's, like I said, control the controllables. I mean, I can't really control none of that. You know what I'm saying? I'm focused on what we got going on right here, and just making sure this team is good and we we go out every Saturday and try to put on a show. So.
Anything else for TJ? Thank you.
Thank you.